The greatest show on earth, it wasn't, but it was the biggest pop concert ever held in Britain. More lights, more fireworks, certainly more hype than any other. Unfortunately, there was also rain last night, pouring down right on cue from the start of the show. However, it didn't dampen the enthusiasm of the 70,000 fans who paid to see Jean Michel Jarre. The French composer got the thumbs up from some of the thousands of Newham residents who watched the show for free.
Oh, it's fantastic. It's good. Very good. Yeah.
You don't mind the noise and everything?
No,
not at all. I think it's a good thing for the community and the area. I think it's a marvellous show. We saw it last night, and as you see, we're here this evening and watch it again.
One of Jean-Michel Jarre's oldest fans was 85-year-old Jim Gain, a Newham resident.
Marvellous. Best I've ever seen. It really is.
But at your age, and you know spring chicken, you should be complaining about the noise and all the people.
That's good music. I like to listen to that music. Some of it's out of rubbish. No, I don't like it. That's all right. Splendid.
However, the rows of empty seats last night testified to the doubts about the concert's financial success. We understand gate receipts for the two nights were just under £3 million. That, plus sponsorship, will struggle to meet costs of around £4 million. Today, promoter Rod Gunner was putting a brave face on things.
Jarre concerts are not particularly financially beneficial. It's regrettable that there was a delay because obviously that meant that the budget went much higher than it was originally scheduled to be, simply because the higher charges for all the equipment and so on had to be held over for, what, another 3 weeks. My instincts tell me that it will be probably just slightly better than break-even.